Hey everybody, Chris of the Procrastinator's Garage. A lot of things going on in the last couple days, well since Friday. I'm gonna set this up somewhere. Well, right now I'm just working on the neon. I'm gonna check the ball joints and tie rod ends. And see if they're vibrating like a bitch. Ball joint seems fine. Looks like tie rod ends. So on this car, you know, I've done the ball joints a couple years ago. I took it into a shop, had them do the ball joints and the tie rod ends. This time I think I'm gonna do the inner and the outer tie rod ends. Yeah, it was raining here earlier, but all dried up already. Getting hot out again. We had a little bit of rain last night. There's a puddle out there still. Yeah, it's getting hot again. Like everywhere else. Just slid forward when I jacked her up. This time I'm going to do the inner and outers, tie rod ends, and then I don't think I'm going to do the ball joints. Ball joints seem fine on both sides. I think probably just need some grease, but yeah, the tie rod ends are just, it's like it's gonna fall apart. So, and it's been like this for like this spring. So, Jess's been driving it a lot, so I need to get it fixed up for her. Set this. So, little update on things. My dad's doing really well. As you saw, he's fishing. So he's back to moving around, still off of work, I think, for another month. He took another extension. Just got a call from, the nurse and that. 2 days ago, they're looking at August 13th of having her surgery for the diverticulitis. Have her section of her intestine, and it's like at the very end of your intestines, intestine colon area. She may have to wear one of those bags, temporary things. Kind of sucks for me because I have vasovagal, which I'm prone to fainting. My blood pressure is real variable, goes up and down a lot. If I stand up too fast, I see stars a lot of times. Yeah, I pick detailing as one of the, best jobs for that. I'm always scrubbing the tire, stand up, go to the next tire, stand up. I try and use that stool, that really helps, just wheel around on the stool, especially with like waxing and stuff too. Like getting in and out of the car, sometimes I'm bending down, then I get up, I have to be careful, I could pass out. I actually went to the hospital one time. I had insurance. I used to make good money at a floor care company. I was in charge of projects, go around to different accounts, carpets, or floors and all that. But had insurance, so I went in, had a table tip test done. Strap you on a table, put straps across to you. Had me hooked up to a heart monitor, which recorded it on paper, my heartbeat. And then tables motorize, it tips you, it's standing up. And yeah, I passed out, my heart stopped for 10 seconds. And they were ready to defibrillate me when I finally woke up. But yeah, what was I getting at? So yeah, Jess's gonna have her surgery. But with my vasovagal, like the sight of blood triggers it. You know, going to the hospital triggers it. So that's gonna be hard to, you know, like with my dad's surgery and stuff, he couldn't even show me the, you know, there were like two little holes, but you know, I get dizzy and sick. It's, you know, I try and control it, try not to think about it, but it happens. Also, sharp pains trigger it. I passed out in high school. A kid, it was in a graphics arts class where we ran a printing press, screen printed t-shirts, screen printed the big posters for school events, you know, and stuff like that. Wedding invitations. I actually printed up my mom and dad's wedding invitations because I was in high school at the time. I had that class when they got married. So that was pretty cool, you know, got to do a lot of stuff like that. Well, he was running an offset press, Chief 17, I'm pretty sure it was. The paper feeds in this way, and then there's your two drums, you know, that go that way. I don't know if I'm on camera, and you know, me, that's where that runs through. He got his finger caught. Somehow, he was, I think, trying to grab something, and maybe a chunk of piece of paper or something, a torn piece of paper, and he got his finger nipped off. I saw the blood trail. I put my head down on the table, like, you know, like this. Next thing I know, I was laying on the ground, and there was paramedics and firefighters, you know, all around. I had somehow, you know, when I passed out, I spun around and I just smacked my head right on the concrete. It was a concrete floor in that class. And suffered a major concussion, and I was in and out of consciousness. And, you know, but I kind of thought it was a fluke thing, you know. But then, back in, I don't know, had it been 98 or so, I was at my grandparents. Me and Jess and my grandpa were out in the garage smoking a cigarette. I got this bad sharp pain in my stomach, and I knelt down, and then I passed out, I guess. So I just got insurance a month before through the job I was working, and so I went to the doctors, you know, and I had that test done and found out that's what I had, vasovagal. So yeah, it's hard for me to go to the hospital and family members are there, can't see the tubes and all that, or else, you know. Because I went, you know, after I was released from the hospital, when Scott got the tip of his finger nipped off, I went to go see him before I left. And he was laying in the hospital bed, had his hand up here. Yeah, and I almost passed out in there, so we had to get out of there. And it was kind of funny, I joined the Navy, and when I got to my first duty station, all my luggage was lost, all my uniforms and everything. So when we were in Bahrain, I had to meet up with another supply ship that, you know, I could go buy some uniforms. And here Scott was standing on the pier. And yelled at me, and I was like, wow, you know, it was kind of weird to see him halfway around the world. So, last couple days, let's see, Friday, a friend of mine, Matt, used to work with him at the cleaning company. He worked at the Nestle's plant as a janitor, but I used to do floors out there all the time. Became good friends, you know, always kept in touch. He's living back with his parents. He just got out of Stevens Point for a forestry degree. so he's trying to find a job doing that. Probably going to be going out west. But he had to sell his Saturn he had. You know, it had like 300,000 miles on it. You know, I did some head gasket work for him before with a stop leaf. We did that at my house years ago. He actually made it though out of California two times. You know, he drove out and drove back home. Still ran when he sold it. He got $300 for it, so got a fly now. But he found a car on Craigslist, a 95 Honda Accord. For $975 it was listed, but he got it for $800. Very good running car. I mean, when we first checked it out, started right up, no knocks, no ticks. The oil was pretty decent, you know, so I know there wasn't like a lot of additives in it and stuff. You know, it was real thin. So you think, you know, the car sitting, the car was cold, you know, he didn't start it up before we got there. So, ran good, did have a little shake in it. And then, so he ended up buying the car. Speedometer didn't work. He ended up buying a GPS, so he's gonna put that in over the speedometer. But, you know, we brought it to the shop on Saturday. Well, actually, he brought it to my house because, you know, he didn't have plates or insurance. And he was living in Bloomer at the time. And he had his parents' car, you know, he drove to my house. We went and got this car. It was actually out of town, a little couple hour, like 2 hour drive there and back. But, brought it to the shop Tuesday or Saturday, and you know, I jacked it up. I checked the ball joints, tie rod ends for him. The one tie rod end on the passenger side was bad. The upper ball joint was bad on the driver's side. He priced around, you know, parts and other shops for doing the work. He decided to go with Rich. Rich charges $45 an hour. So we set up a time for Tuesday at 2 o'clock. Rich was supposed to be here. Me and Matt actually got here. Yeah, I need a rebuild kit for my jack. Got a slow leak here and I jacked it up. She's going down. Real slow. I always use jack stands when, you know, I'm gonna be under the car. But just for checking the ball joints and stuff, no big deal. But so yeah, you know, I shampooed the interior and stuff. I'll have to get a video after pictures and video yet. I do got some before pictures I took. I didn't take any video while we were doing the work. I kind of wish I would have, but I wasn't really in the mood. A lot of things going on. I may have to file bankruptcy for the business and just close down. I've been trying to ask my dad for help, just even for a newspaper ad. It's about $150. That really helped me last year at May. I put one out and it was $10 off a wash and a wax. And I actually got a lot of people calling and coming in to have the bronze and gold details, which, you know, my wash and wax is a $30 for a car, $50 for a truck, $10 off. So, you know, that was kind of a pretty good deal. But I wanted to get people in. You know, I was just opening up, wanted to get that word of mouth going. It's gonna be a long video. I'm rambling. I think it's the most I've been on camera too. But my mind's just going a mile a minute. Okay, so me and Matt got here a little early. We had to go pick up parts and stuff. He bought an upper ball joint, lower ball joint, and sway bar bushing, the end links. Bushings were all friggin' just dry rotted, so I told him, yeah, you know, because he might end up taking the car out west again, so, you know, it was one of those things, might as well do it, you know. He had the extra money, he had more than, you know, enough that he was planning on spending the car, and he spent about half of what he was planning on spending. So he has that little extra money to put in the mechanically. So Rich was supposed to be here at 2. He didn't get here until 6 o'clock. So that was pretty, I was pissed. You know, I had the car all shampooed and everything by 5 o'clock, you know, so we had to sit around here. And then he didn't get done until 10 o'clock. Couldn't get the lower ball joint out, so he had to run to a buddy's house and use his press. You know, I wish I had a press, you know, it's one of those things. You don't use a whole lot, but, you know, he had the ball joint press, but the way the it was set up, he couldn't get the press in there to push it out. He could use it to push it in. So he had to run and go do that. So, you know, that took over an hour. So it only took him like 3 hours. But it was still, you know, if he would have got here at 2, he would have been done by 6. You know, and then I would have been home. You know, I didn't get home until 10:30, 11 o'clock that night. You know, and I had to have the lights on for 4 hours and the air compressor, you know, running. Later on, you know, I was using the air compressor earlier here and there, but we could have switched off, you know. And then, So he charged him, I think, 180, you know, which still, you know, is a good.